In this section of this complete Node.js course, we are going to talk about the basics of MongoDB database and how to use it with Node.js. Here, I'm only going to cover the basics of MongoDB which you need to know for this course. But if you want to learn about MongoDB in details, you can check my MongoDB course on this YouTube channel. There, I have covered the concepts of MongoDB in great depth. So if you want to learn about MongoDB from scratch and in depth, that course is for you. Now, let's start this section of this Node.js course by understanding what is MongoDB and its features and how it is different from traditional database solutions. To understand MongoDB, we are going to compare it with more traditional database solutions like MS SQL or MySQL or Oracle, which are also called as relational databases. So in a relational database, we have database at the top. In the MongoDB also, we have database at the top. So as we already know, MongoDB is obviously a database solution, right? But it is a so-called NoSQL database solution. In a NoSQL database solution, we don't store data in tabular format. Okay. Now, in a relational database, a database contains tables like customer table, product table, orders table, etc. But a database in MongoDB contains collections. We do not have tables in MongoDB, we have collections. So, if you are coming from a relational database background, you can think of a collection as a table of data. Then, in relational database, each table has rows. Each row contains a data about a single entity, for example, one customer or one product or one order, etc. But in MongoDB, each collection consists of one or more data structure called as documents. You can think of a document as a table row if you are coming from a relational database background. Each document also contains a data about one single entity, like one customer, one product, or one order, etc. So we can say that a collection is basically a collection of documents. For example, a customer's collection for all customers, or a product's collection for all products, or order's collection for all orders, etc. Also keep in mind that a document stores data in JSON-like data format. Now, this will make our job a lot easier when we start dealing with documents from our Node.js application, because dealing with JSON data in Node.js is a lot easier, right? We have already seen how to work with JSON data in our previous lectures. And since MongoDB is going to return us JSON data, we don't have to perform extra operations on the data which we are receiving from the database. And in this way, it is going to make our job a lot easier. So, if we have to represent a customer data in a relational database, we will represent it something like this. So we will have a database. In that database, we will have a customer table. And in that customer table, we will have customer related rows. So each row here in this table represents one customer. But if we have to store customer related data in MongoDB, in a NoSQL database, there instead of table, we will have customer collection. And in that customer collection, we will have documents. So this one JSON object is one document. The second JSON object is second document. So each document here represents one customer data. And as I have mentioned earlier, a document is nothing but a JSON object. In that JSON object, we will have fields, and a field consists of a key and a value. Now we will talk about documents in great detail in a bit, but first let's see some of the important features of MongoDB database. So from what we have learned so far about MongoDB, we can say that MongoDB is a document-oriented, non-relational NoSQL database solution. MongoDB stores data entity in the form of document, so it is a document-oriented database solution. In a document, the data is basically stored as a JSON object where we have fields. Each field is a key-value pair. And that's why MongoDB is a NoSQL database, because here, data is not stored in a table. Here, the data is stored in JSON format. Also, MongoDB has a built-in scalability, making it very easy to distribute data across multiple machines as your app gets more and more users and start generating a ton of data. Another important feature of MongoDB is its great flexibility. Unlike relational databases, a collection in MongoDB is schema-less. You don't need to define a schema for your documents in a collection. Documents in the same collection can have different number of fields and different type of fields, and MongoDB will not complain about that. Okay, so in that regard, MongoDB is very flexible, because in the same collection, you can have documents with different schema. MongoDB is also a very performant database solution. This is because of the features provided by MongoDB like embedded data model, indexing, sharding, flexible documents, native duplication, etc. Finally, I also want to mention that MongoDB is a free and open source database solution published under SSPL license. So in summary, we can say that MongoDB is a great database system to build many types of modern, scalable, and flexible web applications. And in fact, MongoDB is probably the most used database with Node.js, and that's why it's a perfect fit for us for this course. Now, as we learned, a document is basically a JSON-like object. Here is an example of how a single customer data will look like in a document. And this is how it will look in a relational database. There, we might have a customer table, and in there, we will have some rows for each customer. Now, this data format here, it is not exactly JSON, but it is called as BSON. BSON is basically JSON data with support of extra data types like dates, different integer types, object ID, and binary data, etc. So this data here, it looks exactly like JSON data, but it is typed, meaning that all values will have a data type, such as strings, booleans, etc., along with some extra data types. And you will learn about these data types in practice in future lectures. So just like JSON, the BSON data also has fields, and the data is stored as a key value pair. If you want to compare field of a document with relational database, basically each field of a document corresponds to a column of the table row. Now, in a document, a field can also store a list, that is, it can also store an array. But in a relational database, that is not allowed. There, a column cannot store multiple data, and we need to find a workaround for that. But that's not the case in MongoDB, and this is the flexibility that MongoDB provides. Another important feature which MongoDB provides is the concept of embedded documents. Basically, using embedded document concept, we can store documents in a given field. This allows us to avoid complex relations, which we need to do in case of relational database. In a relational database, we create relations between the tables, as you can see here. So in this employee table, instead of storing the gender, the actual gender, we are storing an ID. In the same way, instead of storing the actual country, we are storing a country ID. And then these two columns of this employee table is related to the country table and the gender table. Okay, and in this way, in a relational database solution, we have related tables. But that is not the case in case of NoSQL database like MongoDB. So this process of embedding documents, it basically allows us to include some related data all into one single document. In this example, these two orders are related to this particular customer. And so these related orders are stored in one of the same document. And this makes MongoDB database high performant because here we do not need to query multiple collections. All the related data is present in the same document. But in case of a relational database, if we want to get, let's say, the employee data with employee's gender and country, then in there, we will have to do some joins between this employee table and country and gender table in order to provide the proper data to the user. So here, we need to query three tables in order to get the proper data. But that's not the case here. Here, in the same document, we have all the related data. So here, we only need to query one collection. From there, we can get all the related data. And this makes the NoSQL databases like MongoDB high performant. Now, there are a few things which you need to remember about a document. The first thing which you need to remember here is that the maximum size of a document cannot exceed 16 MB. Okay, and here I'm talking about the outermost document and not embedded documents. So this document which you see here, its size cannot exceed 16 MB. Now, this document also has some embedded documents, but the 16 MB limit is for overall document. Secondly, we learned that we can have embedded or nested documents. If you notice here, this document has some nested documents. So the maximum depth of nesting is 100. That means this document has some embedded document. This embedded document can also have some embedded document. That embedded document can also have some embedded document. So this level of embedding can go up to 100 levels. It cannot exceed that. Okay, so the maximum depth of nesting is 100. And finally, each document which is created in the MongoDB database, it is going to have an object ID. Okay, it is going to have this underscore ID field, and it gets assigned with an object ID. And that object ID gets created automatically. We don't have to provide that. It gets created automatically. Of course, it is possible to manually set the value for this underscore ID field. But if you don't provide that value, then MongoDB will automatically generate that object ID and it will assign it to this underscore ID field. All right, so this was a brief overview of MongoDB, and this should be enough for us to get started. Now in this course, as I mentioned earlier, I'm not going to cover MongoDB concept in deep. I will only cover those topics which is required for this course. But if you want to learn MongoDB in depth, I already have a course on MongoDB on this YouTube channel. You can learn MongoDB in depth from there. I will share the link in the description. This is all from this lecture. Thank you for listening and have a great day.